What's up, guys? This is Chris from DraftDashboard.com.
Here are my DFS picks for NFL Week 5, Monday Night Football.
These picks apply for DraftKings and FanDuel. Before I get started, please drop a like on this video and hit that red subscribe button.
And hit that bell icon
so you don't miss our new videos.
Okay, guys, in this video, I'm going to give you my top DFS picks for this Monday Night Football showdown between the Las Vegas Raiders and the Kansas City Chiefs. And if you stick around to the very end of this video, we'll use the Draft Dashboard tools to make a DFS lineup using the picks we just made. Okay, guys, let's take a look at this NFL showdown between the Las Vegas Raiders and the Kansas City Chiefs. So at the quarterback position, I think you can play either one of these quarterbacks. So let's start with Patrick Mahomes from the Kansas City Chiefs playing the Las Vegas Raiders, who have the 10th worst defense overall. They give up the absolute most fantasy points to opposing quarterbacks. Patrick Mahomes has averaged 24.4 fantasy points per game on the season, getting an average of 3.3 rush attempts per game. He's projected at 24.1 fantasy points here tonight. He's 12,000 DraftKings salary, and Vegas thinks there's going to be 52 points scored in this game, with the Kansas City Chiefs favored by 7.5. Patrick Mahomes has scored 24, 18, and 17 fantasy points in the last three games. He got 4, 4, and 2 rush attempts in those games. So fantastic matchup here. We know Mahomes has monster upside. So I like Patrick Mahomes here versus the Las Vegas Raiders. Now, if you want to save some salary at the quarterback position, go ahead and plug in Derek Carr from the Las Vegas Raiders playing the Kansas City Chiefs, who have the 9th worst defense overall. They give up the 4th most fantasy points to opposing quarterbacks. Derek Carr has averaged 17.8 fantasy points per game on the season, getting an average of 2.5 rush attempts per game. He's going to be about 59% owned. Compare that to Patrick Mahomes, who's going to be about 62% owned. So the ownership here is almost split down the middle. So Derek Carr is projected at 18.6 fantasy points here tonight. He's 10,200 DraftKings salary. So you're getting a pretty good salary savings if you go with Derek Carr over Patrick Mahomes. And Derek Carr, if he's going to be fall behind in this game, Vegas thinks they're going to be trailing by 7.5. So he could have to push the ball down the field. He could get a lot of pass attempts in this one. So Derek Carr has scored 12, 24, and 19 fantasy points in the last three games. So I like Derek Carr here versus the Kansas City Chiefs. Okay, let's take a look at the running back position. So for the Las Vegas Raiders, you have Josh Jacobs, who's averaging 17.4 fantasy points per game on the season, getting an average of 17.5 rush attempts per game and 3.3 pass targets per game. He's been on the field for 72% of the snaps, gonna be about 51% owned, projected at 15.9 fantasy points here tonight. He's 8,800 DraftKings salary. Now, Josh Jacobs has scored 38, 15, and 9 fantasy points in the last three games, off of 28, 13, and 19 rush attempts, on top of 6, 6, and 1 pass targets. So, monster volume here for Josh Jacobs. So, I like Josh Jacobs here versus the Kansas City Chiefs. Now, for the Kansas City Chiefs, you have Clyde Edwards-Helaire, and he's averaging 18.9 fantasy points per game on the season. He's only getting an average of 10.3 rush attempts and 3.5 pass targets per game. Now, he's only on the field for 45% of the snaps. He's going to be about 26% owned, projected at 13.6 fantasy points here tonight. He's 7,400 DraftKings salary. Now, although the volume is not super high here for the season for Clyde Edwards-Helaire, he did get 19 rush attempts and 2 pass targets last game, scored 22 fantasy points. Now, I think I prefer Josh Jacobs, but if you can't afford Josh Jacobs, then I'd go with Clyde Edwards-Helaire. So I like Clyde Edwards-Helaire here versus the Las Vegas Raiders. Now, if you're looking to save some salary and go with a sleeper pick, this is a guy that got 11 rush attempts last game. So not a ton of volume, but he is only 4,800 DraftKings salary. And they keep talking about this guy like they want to give him more action, like he's a secret weapon they've been hiding. So take a look at Isaiah Pacheco.
Before I continue with the picks, I'm excited today because we added a new contest for everyone watching.
If you want to enter the drawing for $25 PayPal,
all you need to do is like this video, hit that subscribe button, and make a quick comment below to be entered into the drawing. We'll reply to a random comment and let you know that you won.
And we'll send you $25 PayPal.
So it's that easy, and we pick a new winner every Saturday and announce them in our video. So get your comment in now so I can add another entry for you.
From the Kansas City Chiefs, can't even say his name yet because he really hasn't played that much, but I think this guy is a deep sleeper pick. He's only going to be about 4% owned. Now, he's only 4,800 DraftKings salary. This is a high-risk, high-reward play here, but if the Kansas City Chiefs somehow get a 2-touchdown lead and they're going to run the clock out, you can look for Isaiah Pacheco here versus the Las Vegas Raiders. Okay, let's take a look at the wide receiver position. So the stud on the slate, Davante Adams from the Las Vegas Raiders. Now the Kansas City Chiefs, they give up the ninth worst defense overall. They give up the ninth most fantasy points to opposing wide receivers. Davante Adams has averaged 19.8 fantasy points per game on the season, getting an average of 11.8 pass targets per game. He's on the field for 97% of the snaps, gonna be about 54% owned, projected at 19.2 fantasy points here tonight. He's 11,400 DraftKings salary. Now, Davante Adams could get a lot of pass attempts in this one, especially if the Raiders fall behind. He scored 23, 14, and 9 fantasy points in the last 3 games off of 13, 10, and 7 pass attempts or pass targets. So I like Davante Adams here versus the Kansas City Chiefs. Now, another guy for the Las Vegas Raiders who's making his return on the season, he was out for a couple of games, is Hunter Renfrow from the Las Vegas Raiders, and he's averaging 8.5 fantasy points per game on the season, getting an average of 8 pass targets per game. He's going to be about 44% owned, and he's projected at 11.3 fantasy points here tonight. And before he went out with injury, he scored 12 fantasy points off of 10 pass targets. So he gets plenty of volume when he's healthy and in there, and his salary is still pretty low. So I like Hunter Renfrow here versus the Kansas City Chiefs. The other guy from the Las Vegas Raiders you can consider is Mac Hollins. And he's averaging 13.4 fantasy points per game on the season, getting an average of 6.3 pass targets per game. He's been on the field for 92% of the snaps, going to be about 27% owned, projected at 7.5 fantasy points here tonight. He's 5,000 DraftKings salary. Now, with the return of Hunter Renfrow, that might take a little bit of the shine off of Mac Hollins, but he is $800 cheaper, and I think he's still in a good spot here. Mac Hollins has scored 6, 33, and 12 fantasy points in the last three games off of 5, 10, and 8 pass targets. So I like Mac Hollins here versus the Kansas City Chiefs.
Real quick, guys, I got great news. For a limited time, we're offering a full 30-day trial to Draft Dashboard. You can try all the tools for NFL. NBA is right around the corner. This is a great time to get in and try everything for 1 month. The tools are all about saving research time. You can see the last three games, the fantasy points per game, the targets they got per game, so you can see how involved they are in the offense, the rushes they got per game. Seeing all this stuff on one screen helps you save time and make better picks. Oh, and if you're tired of doing research every day, we just added a cheat sheet that shows hand-picked plays for the slate. No confusing stat lines, no headaches, just a simple cheat sheet that shows the absolute best players for your lineups.
Now, another guy right around the 5K range is Marcus Valdes-Scantling from the Kansas City Chiefs. He's averaged 7.4 fantasy points per game on the season, getting an average of 5.8 pass targets per game. He's going to be about 28% owned, has been on the field for 74% of the snaps, projected at 10.2 fantasy points here tonight. He's $5,200 DraftKings salary. And Marquez Valdes-Scantling has scored 9, 9, and 3 fantasy points in the last 3 games off of 5, 7, and 7 pass targets. So I like Marquez Valdes-Scantling here versus the Las Vegas Raiders. Now, for the Kansas City Chiefs, Juju Smith-Schuster is questionable. So just keep an eye on that. If Juju Smith-Schuster doesn't play, that's going to bump up a guy like Mecole Hardman and Marquez Valdes-Scantling. Both of those guys' value is going to go up quite a bit if Juju Smith-Schuster doesn't play. Now, if Juju does play here tonight, I think he's an okay play. He's averaging 10.1 fantasy points per game on the season, getting an average of 6.8 pass targets per game. Going to be about 36% owned if he does play. Projected at 12.8 fantasy points here tonight. He scored 10, 14, and 4 fantasy points in the last 3 games off of 8, 8, and 3 pass targets. Now, he was limited in practice on Saturday, so I have a feeling he's going to be good to go. So I like Juju Smith-Schuster here versus the Las Vegas Raiders. Okay, moving on to the tight end position, the stud on the slate, Travis Kelce from the Kansas City Chiefs playing the Las Vegas Raiders. Travis Kelce has averaged 20.3 fantasy points per game on the season, getting an average of 8.5 pass targets per game. He's been on the field for 80% of the snaps. Going to be about 49% owned. Projected at 19.1 fantasy points here tonight. He's $10,800 DraftKings salary. Travis Kelce has scored 24, 18, and 10 fantasy points in the last 3 games off of 10, 8, and 7 pass targets. So I like Travis Kelce here versus the Las Vegas Raiders. Now, the other tight end that I like is Darren Waller from the Las Vegas Raiders playing the Kansas City Chiefs, who give up the 5th most fantasy points to opposing tight ends. Darren Waller has averaged 9.9 fantasy points per game on the season, getting an average of 6 pass targets per game. He's been on the field for 73% of the snaps, going to be about 25% owned. Projected at 12.2 fantasy points here tonight. He's $7,200 DraftKings salary. Darren Waller has scored 5, 5, and 17 fantasy points in the last 3 games off of 5, 5, and 8 pass targets. I've been a big Darren Waller fan since the start of the season. He hasn't really produced much so far. He's been kind of disappointing. But I think that makes him a good play here tonight as his ownership is going to be down. Salary is reasonable. And the game script could go his way with a lot of pass attempts. So I like Darren Waller here versus the Kansas City Chiefs.
If you want to try all these daily fantasy tools for yourself, click the link in the description below this video or just go to draftdashboard.com. You can use our DFS lineup optimizer to build quality lineups using our picks and your own custom player pool. Click the link in the description below this video and try all these daily fantasy tools right now. Thanks so much for watching. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit that bell icon so you can get instant updates whenever we post a new video.
Thank you so much for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, please smickety smash that like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Oh, and please comment below with your favorite player for this NFL slate. I love to hear what you guys have to think. Thanks again and good luck.